Welcome to ExcelBerry, where we're going to make Excel your go-to tool. In this video, you'll learn about the XLOOKUP function. It's one of the most valuable functions within Excel. It came out 2021, so just a couple of years ago, and it replaces the VLOOKUP and the HLOOKUP, and it's so much better. So if you've learned the VLOOKUP function, then replace it with this XLOOKUP function. And in this video, you'll learn all about it. And if you want to learn even more, you go to my course on excelberry.com. So what does the XLOOKUP function do? So let's say you have your Excel file with values for each month. So you have your berries here, and you've already have the values for January. Now you go and extract a report from a system with values for February, and you want to transfer these values to February in your Excel file. Then you probably need a lookup function, and the XLOOKUP function in this case is the most valuable one. So let's go through it more deeply. So the definition of the XLOOKUP function is that it searches a range for a match and returns the corresponding item in a second range. So it's useful when you will retrieve a value from somewhere else when both places has values that matches in a second range. So the match concept is really important here. So you need an item in both your files that you can match with. So if we go back, you need the berries to be exactly the same in both files. Then you can match on these and then retrieve the values that you're looking for. So the XLOOKUP function has six different arguments. The first argument is what you want to search for. So let's try it out. So when we select a berry here, so we can pick from all the five berries, let's pick blueberry. So now we want to retrieve the quantity for blueberry. So we'll use the XLOOKUP function. So the first argument is the lookup value. Here you can either select the cell, which is the best way to do it right now. You can also write blueberry if it's only blueberry, but when the cell changes, this won't change. So we go with the reference to 810. Then we go to the second argument, which is the range to search for the lookup value. So you could either search the range B3 to B7, or in this case, and how the data usually are structured, you could pick the entire B column. But you need to keep in mind that the second and third argument needs to have the corresponding length. So if you take only the five cells here in the second argument, you need to take only the five cells in the third argument as well. But in this case, I'll take the entire B column. I go to the third argument, and this is the return array. Let's say you look for blueberry in this column, and it will go from the top to the bottom. So it will search in B1, B2, B3, B4. Oh, I found it. And now you select the columns that you want to retrieve values from. So here we want to select the entire C column. But you can also actually, with the XLOOKUP function, retrieve multiple columns at the same time. So you can select the entire CDE column if you want to retrieve the quantity, price, and total directly. But in this case, we only take the quantity. And the XLOOKUP function has six different arguments, and the three first one are mandatory to use. So we can actually close the bracket and press enter, and we will retrieve the quantity for blueberry. And if we change the berry to blackberry, the quantity will change as well. So let's go through the other arguments. So the fourth argument is a built-in if error function. So if you're familiar with the VLOOKUP, you usually nest it within an if error function, but here it's already built in. So what should happen if you do not find the blackberry in this case, so your lookup value in the lookup array? If this argument is omitted, then it will be an error message. So instead of an error message, what should happen instead? A common thing to write here is either zero, so the value zero, or if you want to have a blank cell, then you do two quotation marks. That means text with no text inside. So text, but you skip the text, so there's nothing in there. So that's the fourth argument. Then we have the fifth argument, which is the match mode, and default for the XLOOKUP function is to be an exact match. And that differs from the VLOOKUP function, where you needed to write false in the last argument. But here you also have the option to use a wildcard, or you could match on the next smaller or larger item. So if you search for a value and if you don't find the value, you could go to the next higher or lower value. Then we have the fifth argument, which is how you want to search. I've probably never used this one, but if you want to search from the bottom to the top instead, or from the right to the left, then you use this sixth argument. So we don't need these for this case, so we only have the three first one, and press on enter. So with the VLOOKUP function, you needed the berries in this case to be to the furthest left, and the XLOOKUP function doesn't really need that. And you can also do it with rows instead of columns, which we did now. So it's both the VLOOKUP and the HLOOKUP in the same. And also if you change the order of the columns, so for example, if you put the quantity here, then the XLOOKUP function will change as well. And that was not the case with the VLOOKUP function, because there you had the number. So that's also a big improvement from the VLOOKUP function. And some things you need to know. So as a default, you need to have an exact match. So sometimes when you extract a file from a system, maybe there's a space where you don't want it. So it's not an exact 100% match. So then you need to make sure that it is. And it will match on the first value only. So you will only retrieve one value. And if you, for example, would have a lot of different berries here, but you have duplicates and you want to have the quantities for all blueberries or all strawberries, then you would use the sumifs function instead for the XLOOKUP function, because the XLOOKUP function only retrieve for one item. And it doesn't matter whether or not this was written in lower cases. So blackberry in this case works as well as with a capital B. But one of the most common problem with the XLOOKUP function that I've seen people have are that they try to match a number that's in a text format with a number that's in a number format, and that will not work. XLOOKUP function needs to have the exact same format, and here they are both text values, so it doesn't matter. But if you were to match on the price here, for example, and if the lookup value were written in a text format, then it would not find the price here. So that's all I wanted to tell you in this video. If you want to learn more in Excel, you subscribe. And if you want to go my course, it's a great course where you learn all you need to know in Excel, and that's on ExcelBerry.com. Thank you.